away from the market store today. There's going to be a lot of focus on what's happening on the streets, so to speak, because 11 trade unions have called for a nationwide strike, a strike that is expected to impact banking services. You can see slight emptiness on the streets of Bombay there, which is very, very unusual for a weekday morning. Let's first get across to Arjun Chaudhary, a correspondent who's been trying to gauge the early impact of that strike.
It's a slow day for India today as trade unions across the country called for a nationwide strike against some of the key policies framed by the central government. Now, some of the key demands of these trade unions include concrete measures to contain price rise, strict enforcement of all labor laws and protection of trade union rights. They also want to abolish privatization within the public sector. They also want to stop outsourcing. They demand bonuses for all and also want abolition of the banking and the insurance sector reforms. Now, the banking sector is one such sector which will remain under pressure as a result of this particular strike. Some of the key services which will be impacted are cash transactions, counter tellers, internet banking and ATMs. Now, ATMs are set to function normally, but that will be subject to cash availability. The transport scenario also will be under pressure throughout the country. But within Mumbai, as of now, trains and buses are plying.
Thanks so much for joining us for that quick report. Arjun Chaudhary there checking out what's happening on the streets. Joining us also to talk about some of these demands, Mr. G. Sanjeeva Reddy, president of INTUC, with us. So thanks so much for joining us. Appreciate. You know, I was looking through the list of demands that have been put out by trade unions. It's the same old demands that we've been talking about for years on end now, and there's nothing specific in there that you're actually protesting, isn't there?
Yes, that's the old demand for last 2 years. We are discussing with the government and we placed before the government for last 2 years. And we are discussing, but no result, no serious thought or given over on these issues. Therefore, we are going on a strike to create an...
What specifically, sir? What I want to know, Mr. Reddy, I want to know, so what specifically are you demanding from the government? Is there one, two or three concrete demands or is it just roll back all liberalization
not whole liberalization policy, but the liberalization policy effect is there to all the permanent jobs converting into a contract job. That was one of the major issue where the lakhs of workers was converted into a contract jobs. And they abolishing the permanent jobs, and that is a reducing the income of the workers from 30,000 to 3,000. This is the economical effect badly affecting the working class. So this is the most important point where we are asking the, we have told the Prime Minister that make every contract worker as a permanent worker in the industry, so that the worker can get a fair deal in the job. That is the more important.
And do you think that's feasible? Do you actually think that's feasible for the industry to do, to convert every worker into a non-contract worker? That adds a lot of burden on every individual company and industry.
No, the point is this, you are producing the permanent production. We are asking for a permanent job which was created for the producing permanent production. Where the production jobs are always handled by the permanent workers, not by the contract workers. Only recent past is the because of the global economy has created new atmosphere. We have not seen last 30 years, 60 years in this country that the permanent jobs was be or permanent production was produced by the contract workers.
But Mr. Reddy, one of the reasons why industries and companies have moved towards contract workers is because we don't have flexibility on labor laws. We don't have the flexibility to hire and fire, and hence they go in for contract workers. Do you think there could be a midway found where you allow for some amount of labor legislation change and then say that, you know, only a certain percentage of your workers can be contract laborers?
This is only allegations. I do not think that is reality. Only people who are just blaming the labor and labor legislation. I said today the labor legislation not at all implemented by any employer in the country. That is a basic another demand of ours. The labor law, land of laws, nobody is respecting. And nobody protecting the interest of the worker. That is the most important. You are only seeing the interest of the investment and industries, but the human life, anything should not be developed on the cost of the labor. Labor life, and you are building a nation and you want to build up an economy on the life of the worker. How can it be possible?
Okay, so you're saying we need to find a middle ground. Fair enough. Dr. Reddy, just one last question then. Sir, just one. I have time for one last question. I want to get a sense from you. Sir, just if you can give us a sense, you know, the debate will continue. I want a sense of how many trade unions are supporting you. What is the kind of impact that you're expecting on services today?
No, services is that number of places we are relaxed, you know, we are not going to essential service such as electricity, we are not going on strike, we are in transportation, some of the places we are exempted. Then we are not harsh on the people, we are railway, we are exempted because we do not want to create inconvenience. But ultimately the time is that the end of the day is that what is the right of the workers was taken away by the government and the employers.
Okay.
No, nobody wants to hear a worker who is producing the wealth of the nation.
True. Fair enough, sir. So that's your side of the story. Dr. Reddy there telling us some of the key demands from the union side, and of course services that are going to be impacted. Essential services probably will not be, and that of course is been stated right from the start.
The NDTV news app had redefined the entire genre. Now another market beater. It's already hit number one.
NDTV Profit, India's number one finance app. Download free at ndtvprofit.com/apps. Live stream of NDTV Profit, market news, and your easy-to-manage portfolio. Download now, ndtvprofit.com/apps.